Good morning, Commissioners. Tom Gonzalez, Deputy Director of Public Health. I'm very excited to introduce the next Innovation Award winner, the Electronic Development Review Application Program, known as EDARP. If I may provide a personal testimony here, EDARP has allowed my staff to conduct the required public health review for drinking water and wastewater remotely, thus saving us considerable time, being more efficient, and providing much better customer service. With that, I'd like to introduce my colleague, Mr. Craig Dossie, Executive Director of Planning and Community Development.
Well, good morning, President. Good morning, County Commissioners. Before I get started, this is a great honor to even be in company with some of the other projects that were nominated. I think it says a lot about the county staff that we had that many on the list. I think it was the most we've ever had. So I think it says a lot about county staff. You know, it's today we get to kind of honor something that really changed how we do business every day. You know, I talk about kind of a seismic shift from the voluminous paperwork that we used to get to what is now 100% electronic. That is not a little thing. If you've ever been over to our office and walked through our archives, it's a scary place to be. There's a lot of paper and a lot of rows of files. So EDARP has really changed everything that we do. We're about halfway through. We've done it for all the big projects. We're now working on the things that help mom and pop over the counter and our builders. But this was a huge first step. So I was the one that nominated EDARP, even though it's kind of coming out of our department. The two individuals that worked on EDARP really tirelessly were Mike Rebinar, who's our project management group manager, and Dennis Archuleta, who's our administrative specialist. You need people like this because I don't understand any of the lingo they use. So you go ask Dennis about something in EDARP, he usually gives me an answer. And then I turned to Mike and I asked Mike to interpret what Dennis just said. So you really need both of those individuals to get something like this off the ground. So what is EDARP? I know that I've talked to you all about it in great detail, probably more times than you prefer, but we are very proud of it. What EDARP does is it is essentially a web-based program that allows land use applications to be submitted by developers, by builders, commercial and industrial operators, and even single family property owners that want to open a kennel or want to do a daycare. Before, like I said, you would get voluminous submittals. When you talk about a drainage report or a traffic report, these are hundreds of pages. All of that went away. They can all now be uploaded by the applicant through the EDARP system. There are a lot of benefits. We tried to pare it down to a few here. What I've been told by the development community is on the average major development application, those are the ones that you all see in public hearings, it's saving them approximately $2,000 just in printing costs. That's not calculating the soft costs associated with their staff's time and our staff's time of actually going through that when the hard copies were coming in. That's just in printing costs per application. Huge time savings. The industry no longer has to drive into our office to drop off these volumes and volumes of paperwork. Our consultants that we work with routinely, and even mom and pop, can upload it from the comfort of their home, from a beach in Hawaii, from Denver, wherever they're at. So it saves them a lot of time and money associated with that. There's also time associated with the county no longer having to mail out these applications. As you all know, when we receive a major development application, we'll send it out to somewhere between 15 and, in the case of the wind farm or SDS, 50 agencies to review one application. When they get very voluminous, and we're talking binders and binders and binders full of information, that's a cost to the county to mail that out. That sometimes we will pass it on to the applicant, but it does cost the county time and money to process those mailings. We cut down on the timing. You know, a lot of times we hear we can't get through the process, we can't get through the development review process. EDARP has shortened that timeline because there is no longer a lag associated with mailing. We can send our referrals to the state water engineer or Colorado Geologic Survey instantly. As soon as they're submitted, they get a notice that it's in there for them to review. I think the greatest aspect of EDARP is the transparency. I know it's something that you all have focused on, both those of you that have been here for a couple terms and even the newer commissioners. Transparency is a big thing. We work for the public, and with EDARP, everything that we do is now available to the public electronically. I just met with an elderly couple at the counter yesterday, and you never know how it's going to be received, particularly by those individuals, and we walked them through how they can track the project that's coming in next door to them, a small subdivision application. They were ecstatic to see something like that for the public. And so I feel like if we can make their lives easier, I can only imagine how many other lives we're making easier, those that are really engaged in the development review process. So it provides public transparency, but also, again, we send it out to multiple agencies, dozens of agencies, and they can access all the documents. Whatever they want to look at, they can look at. I think that's the epitome of transparency in government. We have nothing to hide. And so everything that we've ever done since 1947 is available online. And we could never say that before today. It also allows us to increase the ability of other county departments. I think Tom touched on that. We're saving the health department time. We're saving the county attorney's office time, parks, public works. They all have access to information that before they would have had to request a hard copy or we would have had to send it to them. So these are just a few of the benefits. Again, we are planning on expanding that, so we're going to celebrate today, but as soon as we get back to the office, we're going to go back to work and continue to expand it. We're looking at creating a couple different modules for inspections and for code enforcement. We are literally a matter of days away from receiving development applications at the front counter on our minor development applications. But to give you an idea of scale, we process about 400 major development applications per year. These aren't 10-page documents. We're talking thousands of pages in some cases. So to be able to do all that electronically and in a much more efficient manner, I think it says a lot about the program, but more importantly, it says a lot about what these guys were able to accomplish. You know, as director, it's easy for me to come up with ideas. Everybody's got good ideas. But it takes folks like Mike and Dennis to understand first what my idea is, because I think sometimes things are lost in translation. But to take those ideas and run with it and to develop something like this. So I'm very honored to present this to Mike and Dennis. I asked them to prepare speeches, but to keep it to less than an hour each. If you know Mike and Dennis, they're both somewhat introverted. So I'm going to ask them to come up and say something. This is a great honor for me.
Yeah, as they're running to the microphone.
I guess Dossie's 20 minutes of talking said it all.
I'm going to take a stab at interpreting. We are very excited to be here today.
My name is Dennis Archuleta. I would like to say that we've been working very closely with a developer over on Regional Building Department. Without his help, I don't think we'd be able to deliver this project. He's a programmer that's worked behind the scenes. As an individual, he is the man that, as a lot of people say, made the magic happen. Software program, a system, is not real. It's invisible until you hit the key and it comes up. Again, I just want to make sure that he gets recognized also.
Fantastic. Anybody else? He's good. All right.
So thank you, commissioners, and thank you to the committee for recognizing this. I will say it's very personal to me. If they hadn't recognized it, I might be outside protesting with signs. So good thing they did recognize us, because this is certainly a game changer for us.
No kidding. Absolutely. All right. Appreciate it.